You're listening to the Mike Holder Show.
Do you mean that rhetorically, or is this just more idle flirtation?
iRadio Mike Holder on Spreaker.com.
the darkness on the Mike Holder Show. Everybody have a good time. And a lot of people are, from what I'm seeing on Facebook, a lot of people hitting the bars tonight on this Thanksgiving Eve. Kind of the new drinking tradition, Thanksgiving Eve at the bars. They say it's the number one sales day for alcohol in the bars is Thanksgiving Eve. Second, believe it or not, is St. Patrick's Day, and third is actually New Year's Eve, and that's by liquor sales, actual beverage sales, because I guess more people are busy celebrating and eating the corned beef on St. Patrick's Day, and of course they're buying the green beer, which doesn't cost as much, except for some who have the Jamesons and the Bushmills. Those were the days. And New Year's Eve, of course, it's the big buffet. And everybody just basically doesn't buy much liquor because they're waiting for that free champagne toast at midnight. And they're paying, what, $50 to get in the door anyway. So there you go. All right. We got an update. The other day we were talking about this girl down in San Antonio in high school down there who was going to be expelled because she refused to wear an radio frequency ID tracking badge, an RFID badge, which basically has a chip and a battery implanted in it so they can track where students are all the time, including after school. Well, Andrea Hernandez won't have to leave her high school for refusing to wear the badge designated to track her every move there, yet her attorneys announced today a judge granted a reprieve, and she can stay at the school until they sort the legal stuff out, I guess. Ah, Big Brother. It's happening. Well, I'm glad she got the reprieve, and I hope she makes her case. The court's willingness to grant a temporary restraining order is a good first step, but there's still a long way to go. Not just in this case, but dealing with the mindset in general that everyone needs to be monitored and controlled. Ah, welcome to the 21st century and how our government feels. Seriously. Yep, they want to monitor and control us. This is the Grinch of the month. Woman calls the cops on Salvation Army workers for ringing bells. Really? For some, the idea of Christmas coming early is anything but welcome. A local shop owner, Sarah Hamilton Parker, tried after years tolling bells sounded by Salvation Army workers for hours on end in front of her store, took matters into her own hands by reaching out to local authorities to complain about the noise. Frustrated business owner explained, for 5 weeks out of every year, from morning to night, she hears those darn bells ringing. It makes me hate Christmas, she says. After asking the Salvation Army directly for peace and quiet, and after attempting to drown out the noise with everything from earplugs and bell-like music in her shop, she finally reached out to the authorities that it falls under the jurisdiction of the city's noise ordinance. However, Police Captain Mike Schwartz felt it did not. He recognized her concern, but it is something the city has given permission for. They don't even let me pick out my own clothes, so I don't even have a say in it, but you do have a voice in city government. These are not backroom decisions. That's bad when you call the cops on a charity. But so is the world today. All right, let's look at this in a light. And I'm not doing this as a criticism, okay? The top five states to be hit hardest by tax increases coming the new year supported re-election of our current president. And they're going to get tax increases thanks to the government. 6.82% increase for New Jersey. Maryland has a rate of 6.74. They're going up. Connecticut going up 6.62%. Ohio also going up 6.15%. Yep. Looking good, folks. Don't eat the mushrooms in California. A third person died from mushroom poisoning there. And then get this. Being a media guy, you have to love this kind of thing. I'm looking at my time real quickly. We'll finish up with this. Kind of your take this job and shove it. Bangor, Maine. Of course, such a big market it is. A long-standing battle with upper management over journalistic practices at their TV station. Co-anchors Cindy Michaels, Tony Cosiglio announced their resignations at the end of Tuesday's 6 p.m. newscast. The two of them have a combined 12.5 years service at the station. They shocked staff members and viewers with their joint resignations Tuesday evening live on the air. Quote, I just wanted to know that I was doing the best job I could and I was being honest and ethical as a journalist. And I thought there were times that I wasn't able to do that. Who broke in with WBII as a sports reporter back in 2006. The vice president and general manager said they weren't shocked. He said, we'll hire experienced people to fill these positions sooner rather than later. Don't get me started. Ivy. Well, kudos to you. All my best to you too, and hopefully you will find a new gig very quickly. That's the thing, journalistic integrity. What happened to it? There's no more news anymore, it's opinion. Yeah, we all give opinion. I do it too, all right? But I also share the news. I give you the news, I give you my opinion after the news. I don't mix the two together. I put it out there, you make your own judgments. That's why I end a lot of things like with a question. What do you think? You can always let me know what you think, too. You can reach out to me at all sorts of places. Reach out to me, of course, on Facebook. Facebook.com/TheMikeHolderShow. Let me know what you think of the show. Tell me, please. Check out my website, MikeHolder.com, where you can find audio demos, all sorts of stuff, and my blog, where every so often I kind of tell it like it is. And, of course, you can follow me on Twitter, at Mike E. L. Holder. That's at MikeELHolder. And for those of you wanting to find the profile, you'll find it. Facebook.com/MikeHolder. Time to get out of here. Why? Because I just gotta. I got long-winded and all this stuff, you know. I do that a lot. But, you know, I'm fine. I'll be all right. I'll live. Everybody have a very happy Thanksgiving, please. Just do it, all right? Please do it. Please do it. And check out the Facebook page in the wall tomorrow for Thanksgiving Day. I'll have the traditional Alice's Restaurant. Enjoy your Thanksgiving. Always look forward and always keep looking upward. Later, y'all!